love you so much.
Yes, Lord.
So much. You're the reason we're here this morning. We just want to encounter you, God. None of this is worth anything if we don't encounter you.
Yes.
So today we can just come in with hearts of surrender. Lord Jesus, right now we lay down our agendas.
Yes.
Right now we forget about everything else that's to come today, and we just give these moments completely wholly over to you, whatever it is that you want to do, Lord God.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Jesus. We're in expectancy for what you're going to do, not just in this house today, but for what you're going to do, God, coming out of this place as the Spirit of God.
Yes.
We see the revival spirit sparking up all over the place. We feel the ground shaking beneath our feet, Lord Jesus. We are in expectancy of the move of God that's going to take place in our community, God. So this morning, we just pour into that. We say, God, let today be the launching pad. Let it be the launching point for a great outpouring of your Spirit on this Pentecostal Sunday. God, today we celebrate you and your Spirit. God, today we celebrate you in a spirit of thanksgiving that you would choose to dwell with us, that you would choose to put the Holy Spirit inside of us, that we could work in communion with you, that we could co-labor with you. You've given us the Spirit of truth, God, and we're so, so thankful for it. We don't take it for granted. For those of us that aren't filled with the Spirit, we cry out today, God, fill us up.
Yeah.
Fill us up with the Holy Spirit. Set us on fire, Lord Jesus. Help us to understand what it means to be full of the Spirit, God, and carry that gifting on our life, Lord Jesus. We love you, and we thank you for all that you are in our lives today, Lord Jesus, as we worship you. Thank you, Jesus. Amen. Everybody says amen.
Hallelujah.
That is the plan of God, that up from the ashes of what's going on in the world right now, that hope will arise, amen. And when we come forth, we're going to emerge stronger than ever before. That's what God does. He turns around what Satan means for harm, and he turns it around for our good. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah.
Stronghold still be loosed. God, we believe. Oh, burn like the fire and blowing like the wind. I went in this morning and I just sat before the presence of God, and the Lord, with intention, brought me to a story about a man that I had written, that I had read about many, many times, but it's been years ago. He had walked into his closet one day after reading how the Spirit of the Lord can change your life and how the fire of God can burn the chaff of sin away from you. And how that he is a consuming fire. And when the kindling of the Spirit sets upon your life, things begin to change. I read about this guy. And he literally took what he read and believed what God was telling him. And the Lord told him to go search out a place. So in Los Angeles, California, he got out the paper and began to look for houses to rent. And he found a house for $8 a month at 312 Azusa Street in Los Angeles, California. His name was William Seymour. And all he did was walk into this house and say, look, we're going to have services here. Anybody that wants the power, help me, and the fire of God to come into your life, you're more than welcome to come into this house. How many know what happened next? Some 47 million people have been affected by what happened on a corner street in Azusa. Here's why I know God told me to read that. Because we are affected in this country with this unbelief. And I think it's time to stand in the face of adversity with the faith that will rise up within us and say, God, all things are possible. Burn like a fire and blow like a wind. I said, burn like a fire.
Oh, Amen. Can you just lift your hands toward heaven right now? In a spirit of surrender, hallelujah. 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 You are my Father, and I know your voice. Dispel all doubt right now in Jesus' name. Spirit of truth reigns supreme in our lives. Yes. Shut the mouth of the enemy. Shut the lies of the enemy.
Yes.
In Jesus' name. Come on, can you worship him? Give him a praise this morning. Yes.